Hello, my name's Lee. Apparently, I've been on the streets for about, for about 3 years now.
How old are you?
Roughly around about 35, really.
Where were you born?
Oh, me. I was born in Hull.
What school did you go to?
Oh, me. I went to, Prior Road is Prior Road, yeah. So. It's only an old school, but I think one of the ladies what was on the buses there, one of them snuffed it now. Dad now. She was a nice lady, weren't she? You know. It's just one of those things when a teacher goes, it breaks a lot of people's hearts.
What subject did she teach?
There was dancing classes, there was at least up to about another teacher in the room, there was at least an artist there. There was a good artist there. He took me into a room. Everybody says that I'm a real good artist. I can draw. There's a lot of people that love me drawings. I can draw some pictures and they just said, you're just unbelievable. You seem to be one of the best drawers I've ever seen in my life. I like it. I like to find a place where it's nice and quiet.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
Because I like Hull. Hull's nice, yeah. There's no problems in Hull. I like Hull. Hull's nice. I like, I like Queen's Gardens. I like Hull. I like some of the places, yeah. But every time when I want to leave places and to find a place nice and quiet, every time when I'm bowling my bike and things like that, there's people in cars just getting on my back, flashing the lights, and everything you say, they're just like, well, flashing the lights and getting on my back, shouting at me names all the time and giving me an hard time and whatnot. Do some kids think they're real cocky and things like that and real hard and things like that? They think they can really look after themselves and they can fight, they can braid the public and things like that, you know what I mean? I ain't even had just getting picked on all the time. There's only one thing I can say about them artists. There's been a bloke who goes to a college, he just get a bit mixed up sometimes when he's doing a bit of drawing. I suppose he does it on paper, but yeah. He's in the classroom, he does a bit of drawing, yeah. But the reason why he went back to, the reason why he went back to college, he was getting a bit mixed up with a bit of painting. He went back to college and explained to the person who was in the art room. He explained to the teacher, see if he can get it all sorted out. He just wanted to stop for a bit to get his picture sorted out. They're not perfect. Well, he did learn him. He did learn him. He can do it now. He couldn't do it at the time, but he can do it now. Okay. Because he's doing his paintings beautiful now. He seems to be a good painter.
Yeah. What's the best thing then about living outdoors?
Well, living outdoors, it does get a bit bad. Well, my family's kicked me out, yeah, for means, yeah. But they've split it up now.
Which is your favourite village?
What, the bestest village going?
Yeah.
I like South Cave. South Cave's nice. I suppose sometimes it can get a bit rough. Sometimes it can. I think it's on a weekend. It's on a weekend. That's what it is. Hull's nice. It's not so bad. I've been a bit depressed about it, really. I think some people have.
When it's cold like this, then, like, what do you do to keep warm?
Oh, me. Yeah. I have a bit of problems with the police. That's it, really. It's the police. There's been a lot of police officers knocking around. The reason why there's a lot of police officers knocking around is because every time when I'm on the streets, there's all sorts going on. There's people, you get the good people, you get some bad people. I thought to myself, well, I'll go on my pushbike, like, do you know, to Beverly. But there's people in cars getting on my back all the time. So I thought to myself, frig it, I'll get onto the motorway to get back to Hull.
Yeah.
They said, oh, where are you from? So I said, oh, I'm from Hull. So they said, so bloody what? So bloody what if you are from Hull? They said, oh, we don't like Hull people. I said, oh, what if we're going to the town centre? Then I'm from Hull, like, what I mean, what if we're going to the town centre? They just said, oh, no, I don't like Hull people.
Who are the kindest people to you?
People just walking past the TV. Near George Street, somewhere around there. Hi, Ness. I like the nurses, they're not so bad.
What do you do if you're not feeling very well? Do you go to a doctor?
A doctor?
Or do you just do you just go to sleep? What do you do?
Oh, me, I just... I have it bad with my back. I got knocked down. A little waiting on my push bike. I went towards another house, I think it was number 3, where the cars was parking. One of them saw me coming down, and he knew I couldn't stop because I didn't have no brakes.
Yeah.
And he saw me going towards the footpath on my push bike. And what did he do? Turned down from the footpath, he saw me coming down on my bike, right? Pulled out a little bit, and he looked into the front window, and he saw, and he said, right, frigate, I'm not going too far on this. I'm not going too far, I'm not backing up. I'm not backing up nowhere. So what I did, I went towards the footpath. I just wanted to have fun, that's all. And apparently what happened was, right, I went towards, right into his car, he smashed my front wheel in. I had bags on my bike, they flew into the garden, into somebody's garden, number 3 it was, in Little Wheaton. I did a somersault, I did a front flip, right into the air. I just got up, she come towards me, she come out the house, she had a big loud bang. She come out the house and she said, right, I'm going to give you some bin liners, can you tidy all your mess up, can you tidy all your tapes up and everything else. I said, yeah, I'll tidy it all up, no problem.
Did you have any brothers and sisters?
I haven't got a sister, I've only got a brother, and that's it.
You ever see him?
I got a cousin, yeah. Don't worry too much. I think they've been missing me in a way, though. They're not all that bothered, really. Well, I am, though.
I think you was about 15, Lee, weren't you?
About 15.
15 year old.
I mean, you've taken a few years on that, haven't you?
It was the first person I ever knew who could moonwalk. You know what I mean? He put a sheet of fly on the floor outside his house and he would do all that, all the moonwalking, all the spinning on his backside, all the spinning on his head. And then he went to sea, didn't you, after that? And he was fishing. I think he was a young lad at 16, 17 year old fishing. And he had a good job, he was smart as hell, and then he fell in with the wrong crowd. He'll tell you that, he fell in with the wrong bloody crowd. They all just went their separate ways after that, and Lee's just stayed where he is. And he's not changed, you know what I mean? He had his bike fixed not so long ago, didn't you?
Yeah.
And he only got farther for that and all.
So that's Lee, and that's how he is, and you're what changed him.
As you can see, he's just how he is now, and that's it. And that will change him now.
Right.
That's because we've often wondered, one day you're going to find him, and he'll tell you that, you're going to find him dead somewhere. Well, likely it's the glue what's keeping him warm. You know what I mean? Because in bloody weathers when we've seen him, you know what I mean? We saw him once up in Railworld, and it wasn't a nice bloody day, you know what I mean? And he was just off, he went on his tour. And that's Lee for you. There she is. Mr. Lee Langman, this is that young man, this is Lee Langman.